Good evening, everyone. I'm David Thomas, and I'd like to welcome you on behalf of the Music Committee to our annual St. Cecilia concert in honour of the patron saint of music. This year, things are slightly different with this concert. Of course, already it is some weeks since St. Cecilia's own day of November the 22nd. But more importantly, of course, we cannot all be here together at the Clubhouse for the concert. But our performers are here, and we are looking forward to performing for you. And I'd like to assure you that we are working completely within the government guidelines with respect to the coronavirus, which are current at the moment. I'd like to explain how the concert will work. This first part has, for practical reasons, been pre-recorded. So I hope you enjoy this first part. At the end of it, there will be an interval of about 10 minutes. During that time, you need to retune to Zoom using the instructions and password that you've already received from the secretary. Before we start, I'd like to pay tribute to the staff here at the club, whose hard work and support have made this concert possible. I particularly want to pay tribute to our technical maestro, Russ, because without him, we simply couldn't have done it. Thank you, Russ, very much for working so hard and for such long hours to make this possible. Our first performer this evening is Francesco Eiberg. Now, Francesco started playing the piano at a very young age and developed a passion for jazz through listening to his father playing New Orleans-style ragtime piano jazz, including works by famous Oscar Peterson and other of the great jazz performers, who were all influential on Francesco in developing his taste and his style of music. He decided eventually that he was not going to pursue a career as a pianist, but studied business and finance at St. Gallen, at Harvard, and at Columbia. And while developing a career in finance, following that university education, he still developed a keen like of and participation in jazz playing. And this evening, he's treating us to one of his own jazz adaptations. Francesco. Thank you. Our next performer is Roland Brandman. Roland is one of our newer members, but this is already his second time performing at St. Cecilia. During lockdown, Roland has been trying to find alternative activities, like so many of us. He's concentrated on improving both his baking and his running skills. So far, he's not been able to combine the two. However, in February, we have Pancake Day coming up. And I think we'll all agree this is his ideal opportunity for combining these two new developed talents that he has. We shall look forward to hearing about his Pancake Day performances. We are expecting him to win whatever pancake race he takes part in on behalf of the Athenaeum. He's also been doing quizzes on the internet during the lockdown. Regrettably, on one occasion, his quiz was gatecrashed by an old acquaintance of his who was not entirely sober and made the rest of the quiz quite difficult for Roland and the other participants. Now, Roland this evening is singing two very well-known songs. In both of them, he will be accompanied by one of our most regular St. Cecilia performers, John Wilson. John is well-known to everybody who takes part in and who listens to music in the club, both as a performer in his own right and also as a very generous and skilled accompanist. During lockdown, he has been fortunate to be able to form a bubble. I've done so myself, a different bubble, and it's been so supportive, especially if you live on your own, having somebody that you can take part in activities with. John, who lives in Cheltenham, has formed a bubble with a local tenor who has what John describes as a wild enthusiasm for singing the entire Lieder repertoire in Russian, German, French, and anything else that's available. So this has been a good experience for John, learning new pieces, sight reading, and being able to perform during lockdown. Now, the first number that Roland and John are performing this evening is Some Enchanted Evening. Now, this, of course, is a number from the Rodgers and Hammerstein musical South Pacific. And right from the start, when South Pacific was first put on, this song has been regarded as one of the greatest songs ever written for a musical. Perhaps, in fact, the greatest song ever written for a musical. So, Roland, thank you very much. Over to you and John.
Enchanted evening, you may see a stranger. Somewhere you'll see her again and again. Some enchanted evening, someone may be loving. You may hear her laughing across across a crowded room, and night after night, as strange as it seems, the sound of her laughter explain it. Who can tell you why? Fools give you reasons, wise men never try. Some enchanted evening, when you find your true
Roland's second number this evening is the Neapolitan barcarolle Santa Lucia, another very famous song. Santa Lucia was in fact Saint Lucy of Syracuse. She came from Syracuse, and was eventually martyred under the Emperor Diocletian. When Roland first sang this song, he was quite a young boy. He was nevertheless singing in Italian, even though he was not quite sure what the lyrics meant. In fact, he thought this was an anthem to the Caribbean island of Saint Lucia, which of course it is, because Saint Lucia is named after Santa Lucia. Although she was born in Syracuse and martyred under the Emperor Diocletian, her tomb is actually, as many of you will know, in Venice. It's in the church of San Geremia in the Canaletto district of Venice. It was originally in a church dedicated to her, Santa Lucia, about 100 yards from where San Geremia is located. However, her church was knocked down in order to make way for the new Venice railway station, which of course is called Venice Santa Lucia. This is not in honour of either the Caribbean island or the railway station. This is the very famous song in honour of Santa Lucia.
Placida è l'onda, prospero il vento. Sul mare luccica la nastro d'argento, placida è l'onda, prospero è il vento, venite all'agile, barchetta mia, Santa Lucia, Santa Lucia, venite all'agile, barchetta mia, Santa Lucia, Santa Lucia.
Our next performer today is Joe Sentence. This is the second time that Joe has performed at the St. Cecilia concert. He's also an enthusiastic member of the Saturday morning piano club, which happens here at the club during more normal times. Like the rest of us, he's been coping with lockdown, and also, like many of us, he found, of course, that he was getting increasingly annoyed about the length of his hair during the first phase of lockdown. So when eventually the hairdressers opened again, he went to the hairdresser and had his hair cut very short just in case. However, I have to say that the problem was that this was so disliked by his wife that she wouldn't speak to him for 3 days. Perhaps that's a story that some of you can also reflect. Now, this evening, he's playing a piece from Schumann's Fantasiestücke, Opus 12. The piece he's playing is called Des Abends, The Evening. So, Joe, over to you.
Thank you.
Before I introduce our final performer in this first part of the concert, I'd like to remind you about what you need to do at the end of this performance. When we have finished this number, what you need to do is you need to retune to Zoom. In order to do that, you need to use the link that's been sent to you by the secretary. And all you need to do is click on that link, and that should take you straight through to Zoom. You might be asked for a password, you might not, but you might be asked for a password, and that password is included in the email message that you have received. So enter it if you need to. The instructions are all given to you on screen by Zoom and are quite clear. So that's what you need to do at the end of this piece. Could I also remind you that there will be a 10-minute interval which will give you plenty of time to do that before we start on the second part of this evening's concert. Now, our final performer in this first part is Laura Morgan. Now, Laura is a professional opera singer and, in fact, has only recently joined the club. As you might guess, during lockdown and the rest of this year, there's been very little opportunity for her to actually take part in singing. But she has used the time, as so many people have, to make herself more aware of nature and life around her. But of course, for Laura, I'm sure we all understand that the most important thing that's happened to her during lockdown is that she's been elected a member of the Athenaeum. And we welcome her very warmly, both to the club and to the club's musical life. Now, the piece that she has chosen to do this evening is L'Invitation au Voyage by Henri Duparc, written in 1870 and based on a poem by Baudelaire. Laura chose this piece because she felt it represented the aspirations that we all have to actually go places once these restrictions have been brought to an end. So we're really looking forward to when we can all accept L'Invitation au Voyage. It's a beautiful piece. And again, like Roland earlier on, she's being accompanied by John Wilson. So over to you, Laura and John.
Thank you. Ooh.